Sir, there is an issue which is contraindicatory to what we are experiencing. The RBI has given guidelines to our banks saying anyone above 60 is not credit worthy, and so we cannot access a credit card, but they will use our money which is kept with them, the savings, and they make money on that, but they will issue a debit card. Now, this is a bizarre concept, sir, because a credit card is not just about getting immediate credit, but it has several social implications and access under emergencies. 60 years plus is no really a liability, because people, longevity has come to India. And unless we make sure that a senior citizen can book a flight ticket, hotel bookings, making transaction online, paying bills. Now, on the one hand, you want a digital cashless India. On the other hand, you will not give credit to people who are 60 years and above. I'm sure here a lot of my colleagues have got it because we are a privileged lot of people. But the average middle-class citizen who has substantial savings in the bank, and the banks come to look at our face and say, are you alive? They want proof of living. They come home and check whether you're alive or dead while they're talking to you. And they tell you this is for proof of life. And after that, they don't give you a credit card. International banks, which do not have an upper age limit, which are functioning in India, are also submitted to the RBI guidelines here. So what they practice in their countries, they don't affect the seniors. But here, when international banks come and you bank with them, you have a limitation on the credit, and you will not get a credit card. So this kind of discriminatory behavior, and when you're trying to facilitate the elders, there are a lot of active, perfectly all right seniors who are functioning and contributing to the economies of this nation. And I think this kind of discriminatory attitude has to be removed at once. Failing which, we are going to have only debit card. Now, sir, India has flight of capital. We have written off unsecured loans. You have given away the commercial banks' unsecured loans to the tune of 21 lakh crore. This government has waived off selected corporates to the magnitude of 16 lakh crore. But they can't give a basic credit card facility to a law-abiding, tax-paying citizen. Multiple scams have happened, sir. The Punjab National Bank and State Bank of India have given unsecured loans to people. We are all aware that Mehul Choksi, Nirav Modi, Jatin Mehta, thousands and crores of rupees has fled
from... Thank you, Maniye Renuka ji.